Welcome to Inside the History, and we're here live on the road on the USS Salem in Quincy, Massachusetts at the former Fore River Shipyard, where both Battleship Massachusetts and Destroyer Kennedy was built. I'm Thomas James Lowney, Gunner's Mate First Class, retired with Dr. John Scholes, and we're here to give you an inside history in both the USS Salem, naval history, and the Fore River Shipyard as well, so we can take you for a walking tour inside the gun turrets, through the magazines, through some of the control spaces, and give you an insight into the history of here at the Fore River Shipyard, where history has been made in Massachusetts and building some of the best ships in the world. And Salem being the last all-gun heavy cruiser built by the United States, and still the last all-gun heavy cruiser still in existence in the world. So, thank you for joining us. We're about to go on board. We'll see you there. We'll give you an insight of the history. Thank you. Welcome back to Inside the History. We're here on board the USS Salem in Quincy, Massachusetts. We're sitting on the fantail now of the USS Salem to give you an idea of what this area is. It's not just a birthplace for a berthing for the ship Salem. This is the birthplace of many warships. Right here on the fantail, you have an overview of the shipyard that used to be here. And it was run all the way up until the 80s, I believe it was.
That's there, correct.
The 80s. And they built everything that you could imagine here. The interesting part of this place is not only did it do warships, but it was one of the largest shipyards in the country during World War II. And not only did she build warships, but she built some of the most famous ships commercially as well. The Commonwealth, I believe, was built here from the Fore River line as well. And she was the first, the Puritan? It was the first electric-powered ship with full lighting and electric capacities. So right now, Fore River, not Fall, but Fore River Shipyard, Bethlehem Steel, was bought out by General Dynamics, and eventually was shut down because of overseas shipbuilding and kind of killed the industry, and we're barely hanging on to it now. But when you look at the history that comes out of here, Battleship Massachusetts being our primary focus since Battleship Cove, as well as the Joseph P. Kennedy Jr., she was built here. They were fitted out right in this area, right at the pier here. The slipway where they came down is now taken up by these silos. But the whole gurney system that built the battleships was here. And in the videos, you can see her sliding down the ways and coming out here behind the power plant. And the bridge in the background that we have now that's been replaced is similar in appearance, but that's been changed out. But the original fitting out pier and the gurney where the keels were laid for Kennedy and Massachusetts are here as well. But the other thing people don't realize is carriers were built here. The Bunker Hill, the Franklin, the Wasp, the first Wasp, the second Wasp, the Lexington, which is still around. A lot of Quincy ships have been built and survived as museums as well. So there's a rich shipbuilding history here because it's part of the history, inside the history, and this is part of Massachusetts heritage. And John and I are trying to get you to feel that we as a state, Massachusetts, have built a lot of history from the Revolutionary War onwards until now, and we're still building.
Yeah, this is an incredible industrial place. In World War II, this is one of three commercial shipyards that built essentially all of the major warships that we built during the World War II era. Anything from cruiser on up to battleship, aircraft carrier, they're all built, if they were built in a commercial yard, in one of these three shipbuilding facilities, Bethlehem, Quincy, New York Shipbuilding in Camden, New Jersey, or Newport News Shipbuilding in Newport News, Virginia. So during World War II, this shipyard employed approximately 40,000 workers, and they ran three shifts a day, 7 days a week, cranking out ships. And they produced a tremendous number of ships, which really helped win the war. They built, not in addition to the Salem, her sister, the Des Moines. Mm-hmm. And as you mentioned, they built aircraft carriers, destroyers. They built anti-aircraft cruisers of the Atlantic class, the San Juan and the San Diego, just ship after ship. Interestingly enough, this shipyard also produced things that didn't really have anything directly to do to ships. When some of the giant telescopes were being built in the around World War One era, they actually built the mechanisms that supported the telescope. And you know, because the Earth rotates, a telescope has to move and rotate like a gun turret. And so, since they had experience in building machinery to high precision that moved like a gun turret, they were actually able to build all of the foundations and machineries that move these huge optical telescopes. For example, I believe Mount Wilson out in California, they built the machinery for it.
Holy moly. It's quite a bit of history that was built here. So many ships, so much history, and a leader in the industry. Battleship Nevada was built here, wasn't she?
That is correct.
Four of a line, Lexington's, and
Bunker Hill.
We mentioned Bunker Hill, the Wasp. The first Wasp was built here. She was a mini version of the Enterprise. She was cost cuts. They had cost cuts back then too, so built during the Depression era as part of the Franklin deal. The cruisers were here, Quincy's.
Bethlehem Quincy's was one of the yards that really specialized in cruisers. Turned out more heavy cruisers than any other yard.
Yep, and St. Paul was built here, same time frame as Massachusetts and Kennedy. And we're lucky to have two ships at Battleship Cove, Joseph P. Kennedy Jr., and she was commissioned up in Boston but built out of here in December of 45. She didn't get to serve in the war, but she's a product of the war and the gearing class. And the Battleship Massachusetts being the only South Dakota built here. The South Dakota itself was built in New York, wasn't it?
New York Shipbuilding.
New York Shipbuilding. Alabama was built in Newport News.
Norfolk Navy Yard.
Norfolk Navy Yard, excuse me. And was it Indiana?
That was built in Newport News.
In Newport News. So the South Dakota class is spread out at your major shipyards to spread the profits and to have a diverse shipyard. But to have such a shipyard here and the history involved, and with the Fore River Line as well. The Fore River Line, it's part of our exhibit and Marine Museum. They built the hulls here, the steel hulls. As a matter of fact, one of the Fore River Line ships, the Massachusetts, she was SS Massachusetts and was at Pearl Harbor, but she was converted in World War One to the Shawnut, I think it was. She was a mine layer to help beat the German U-boat menace by mining up the Baltics, and I believe she was built here. And she went through Pearl Harbor. She was finally scrapped after being restored and raised as the Ogala. She was commissioned as the Ogala. And she was sunk at Pearl Harbor, raised, and put back into service as a mine layer. And she was finally scrapped in 55. So there's a great amount of history in shipyards and producing the ships that made the history that we tried to get out to you here. So...
Oh, one thing we should also point out is over across the way.
Let's take a look.
There is the fitting out pier. Now, when ships are built, they are launched, but they're not complete when they're launched. Many things have to be added on, particularly things like gun directors. Oftentimes, the turrets have to be added, and many, many other things are added. And that's not done here. That's done over there, which is the fitting out pier. And this ship, the USS Salem, was fitted out there. The Massachusetts was fitted out there.
And
the Kennedy was fitted out there.
Joseph
and
P.
many, many, many famous warships of the World War II era were fitted out at that very pier.
Bunker Hill, Philippine Sea, all these major carriers. I'm not sure if the light carriers were built here.
Most of those were at New York Shipbuilding. which was the other yard that specialized in cruisers. They tended to specialize a little bit more in light cruisers,
right?
Although they did build heavy cruisers of the Baltimore class as well. They never built a ship of the Salem slash Des Moines class,
of a finer caliber.
Had they continued to build these ships and complete the 12 that they had originally authorized, then they would have built one or two of them.
Outstanding. So, we have our history, and it's online. You can look at it and look more into it and see the diversity. 40,000 people working here. It's incredible. Well,
and they had to be skilled people.
Skilled labor. It was not simplistic.
This is not unskilled labor to build a ship. It takes a lot of skill.
Different trades, machines, carpenters, ship fitters, welders, pipe fitters, electricians, and down to your skilled painters who did the installations, who the amazing amount of things that came out of this area.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of those during World War II were women who had to come on board,
Rosie the Riveter,
work with the experienced people who were here already. They'd then train up over a period of time as kind of apprentices, and then they'd learn the skill, and from then on, they would do it themselves. Oftentimes, toward the end of the war, when they were getting short of people in the Navy and needed more people to crew the ships, they would actually take shipyard workers, and when they completed a ship, they would then go into the Navy and serve as a crewman on that ship. Very valuable crewmen, because they knew about building ships, and therefore they could fix them.
Exactly. And then you also have the Kilroy was here, and if anyone's familiar with that little ditty that was kind of like your saying of sorts, what do you want to call it, soapbox history. What happened was, in this shipyard, you had an inspector who had to go through the ships and inspect your spaces and tell them they were ready for service and completion. So the inspector was Kilroy. I can't remember his first name.
I believe it was James.
James Kilroy. And he'd go through and he'd look over spaces until it was complete. He would sign it with a pen marker. And Kilroy was here, which means the space was complete. So when these ships, because you were building passenger ships, you were building cargo ships, you were building cruisers, everything. So a lot of troop ships came out of here as well, AKAs and so forth. So they would see these spaces and see Kilroy was here, and they would regurgitate that on stuff as kind of like a rib or a gag, you know, because it was an American-made product and Kilroy was here. So you see it in like Kelly's Heroes at the end of the movie. They write Kilroy was here, and you saw the design that turned into the schnoz in the eye in the hands, because he was an inspector on here. So if you look it up online, you'll be able to see that history, and it was right here at Quincy Shipyard. So as also we have a touring package, and it was a Kilroy was here package that you can tour both Salem, USS Salem, and ships at Battleship Cove in the Marine Museum. So it's a package deal to commemorate Kilroy.
And that's a fascinating way, actually, to see both ships, because then you can compare the two ships, and even though the Salem being commissioned in 49 and the Massachusetts being commissioned in 42 are only 7 years apart, you'll see a lot of the advances that occurred during that period based on wartime experience.
And the similar equipment, because they were built in the same yard, so you can see a lot of things that if you're a technical nut and you start looking around on these ships, you can start seeing the similarities in design and layout and equipment, because they were gotten from the same manufacturers, because it also supported local businesses and equipment ordered in, motors and so forth, that were from outside contractors that helped build the ship, and you can see similarities of both ships. So if you're that kind of treasure hunter and ship enthusiast, you can start picking up those details and stuff, and you can see them in other ships as well. The Lexington's a museum. Let's see, who else was built here as a museum? Well, there are many out there, and I can't get into all the details right now, but hope you take advantage of that, look into it, learn your history, because it is our history here in Massachusetts as well, and it's in the future. If you want to look into it, jump right in and start digging and searching. But for us, we'd like you to like, share, subscribe to us, and learn the history, because inside the history we're trying to teach here is America's history and naval history as well. So we hope to see you out there. We thank you for your time. Take care. Smooth sailing. And from me, Tom Lowney, and John Scholes, thank you.